Welcome to the official YouTube Night News channel. Churchill spent much of his extravagant life on the brink of financial ruin. Washington, Britain's uncertain economic and political outlook caused by Brexit is reminiscent of when its most celebrated statesman flirted with financial and political ruin. In No More Champagne, Churchill and His Money, David Locke explains how Winston Churchill projected a seemingly extravagant image of wealth despite living on the edge of crippling financial debt. He was a very high-risk operator both in his personal finances and in his politics, Locke told CNBC. And what was most surprising was the extent of his gambling and his continuous search for excitement and taking risks. He didn't listen to advisors on money, and he didn't listen to advisors on politics. Locke, a retired banker who spent 4 years researching Churchill's finances, said the British bulldog accumulated a debt equivalent to $4 million in today's dollars by the 1930s. I think bankers basically believed in him, Locke explained, adding that Churchill kept a good relationship with lenders while avoiding to pay his debts. In 1925, Churchill took out an emergency bank loan, bringing his borrowings to £30,000 or $2.1 million at current exchange rates and adjusting for inflation, inflation multiples, UK pound x50. The following summer, he made several budget cuts to Chartwell, his country estate. Nothing expensive is to be bought by either of us without talking it over, Churchill wrote to his wife Clementine, according to Locke. No more champagne is to be bought. Unless special directions are given, only white or red wine, or whiskey and soda will be offered at luncheon or dinner. The wine book to be shown to me every week. No more port is to be opened without special instructions. Cigars must be reduced to 4 a day. None should be put on the table, but only produced out of my case. Thank you for watching.